Hi everyone, good morning all of you. This is Chanti from InfoBuddy and welcome to the current affairs session of 2nd August 2020. This session contains 10 questions. For each question, I will give you 5 seconds to answer. So write down your answers in the comment box. And if you like the video, please like, share and don't forget to subscribe. Coming to the first question of the day. Operation Breathing Space is a joint collaboration mission between which of the following two countries? Recently, an Israel team arrived in India with a multi-pronged mission codenamed Operation Breathing Space to work with Indian authorities on the COVID-19 response. So option C is the correct answer, India and Israel. India's Defense Research and Development Organization DRDO and Israel Defense Ministry Research and Development Team are working together to develop 4 different kinds of rapid testing kit for COVID-19 which can give the result within 30 seconds. The tests include an audio test, a breath test, and thermal testing, and finally a polyimino test. In audio test, a patient's voice would be recorded and evaluated through artificial intelligence and machine learning. In breath test, the patient will blow into a tube that will detect the virus using terahertz, that means high frequency waves. In thermal testing, it will enable identification of the virus in a saliva sample. And finally, in polyimino test, it seeks to isolate proteins related to COVID-19. The kits will be jointly developed after the trials of Indian COVID-19 patients. The tests have already been tried on a small sample of Israeli patients. The Israeli team has bought robotic equipment and wrist monitors that will help doctors and nurses monitor a patient without increasing risks of infection to themselves. The team has also bought 83 advanced respirators to help patients with severe symptoms. What are the benefits with these tests? The success of rapid tests will help India's overworked healthcare professionals who are working experience fatigue. It will also help to address the public impatience over the COVID-19 test. The quicker test will help authorities to take quicker prevention measures, which will reduce the speed of the virus. So Operation Breathing Space is a joint collaboration mission between India and Israel. Next question. Recently, who has been appointed as personal secretary to Prime Minister Narendra Modi? A 2010 batch IAS officer Hardik Satish Chandra Shah. Hardik Satish Chandra Shah has been appointed the private secretary to Prime Minister Narendra Modi on co-terminus basis. He is currently serving as a deputy secretary in the Prime Minister's office. Before moving to the PMO last year, he worked as the personal secretary to Environment, Forest and Climate Change Minister Prakash Javadekar. So option B, Hardik Satish Chandra Shah. Next question. The personalized UPI payment link mpay.me launched by which company? MobiKwik, a digital wallet company, has launched a new UPI link service called mpay.me, which will enable users to send and receive money from any UPI payment app. A link created using mpay.me can be shared anywhere to send and receive money, which will work on mobile as well as desktop. Through this mpay.me, users will now be able to create their own mini private payment gateway using their phone number. To receive payment, the user has to share it with the person on chat, SMS and email, etc. All MobiKwik UPI users who have their personal payment link can use this service. The link can be used through any UPI app like MobiKwik, Google Pay, PhonePe, Paytm, etc. Coming to this MobiKwik, the CEO of MobiKwik is Bipin Preet Singh and the headquarters of MobiKwik is Gurugram. Next question. Which of the following is a part of the National Education Policy 2020? Statement 1. Multiple entry and exit options which appropriate certification to be available in higher education. Statement 2. Board exams for grade 10 and 12 to be discontinued. Statement 3. Gender inclusion fund and special education zones to be set up for disadvantaged regions and groups. Which of the above statements are correct? Under this new education policy, after 34 years, before NPE 1986, after 34 years, the education policy has been changed. Under this new education policy in 2020, multiple entry and exit options with appropriate certification to be available in higher education. Statement 1 is correct. Board exams for grade 10 and 12 to be discontinued. So board exams not discontinued, a modifications made occur in this board exams for 10th and 12th. So statement 2 is wrong. Gender inclusion fund and special education grants to be set up for disadvantaged regions. Statement 3 is correct. So 1 and 3 are correct. Option B is the right answer. A link will be given in the description. Watch the entire New Education Policy 2020. What are the reforms occurred in New Education Policy 2020? Next question. Which country has formally launched full global services of its BeiDou 3 navigation satellite system, that is BDS? BeiDou navigation satellite system. The name BeiDou comes from Chinese word for the Big Dipper and Plough constellation. So it is China's mission. China's BeiDou navigation project was launched in early 1990s. So in 1990s, its navigation launching system has been launched. The system then became operational within China in 2000 and in the Asia Pacific region in 2012. The navigation satellite system was completed in three steps. BDS-1, which provided services to China, BDS-2 to provide services to the Asia Pacific region, and BDS-3 which provides services worldwide. So BeiDou 3 is services for worldwide. What are the features? A hybrid constellation consisting around 30 satellites in three kinds of orbits, that is geostationary orbit, inclined geosynchronous orbit, and medium earth orbit GEO, IGSO, and MEO. Provides navigation signals of multiple frequencies and is able to improve service accuracy by using combined multiple frequency signals. It offers accurate positioning, navigation, and timing, as well as short messaging communication, international search and rescue, satellite based augmentation, ground augmentation, and precise point positioning. The services are used in various fields by China, including defense, transportation, agricultural, fishing, and disaster relief. It will be the fourth global satellite navigation system after the USA, it is GPS, and Russia's GLONASS, and European Union, Galileo. So BDS is the fourth navigation satellite system. First one is USA's GPA, second one is Russia's GLONASS, third one is European Union's Galileo. It is said to be much more accurate than the USA's GPS. Global Navigation Satellite System is a general term describing any satellite constellation that provides positioning, navigation, and training services on a global basis. So, BeiDou 3 is the navigation satellite system for China. Next question. Ministry of Human Resource Development, MHRD, has been renamed as Ministry of Human Resource Development has been renamed as Ministry of Education. After 34 years, the education policy has been changed. So, Union Cabinet approved the change of name Ministry of Human Resource Development to Ministry of Education. Option A is the correct answer. For full details on New Education Policy 2020, watch the video in our channel. Link has been provided in the description. Next question. Recently, PM Narendra Modi along with Pravind Jagannath inaugurated the Supreme Court building of which country? Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Mauritian counterpart Pravind Jagannath will jointly inaugurate Mauritius' new Supreme Court building, which has been constructed with Indian assistance. So, Mauritius. Option A is the correct answer. The inauguration is scheduled to take place through video conferencing in the presence of senior members of the Mauritian judiciary and other dignitaries from both the countries. The building has been constructed with India's grant assistance and will be the first India-assisted infrastructure project with the capital city of Port Louis. The new Supreme Court project is one of the five projects being implemented under the special economic package of $353 million extended by India to Mauritius in 2016. The project has been completed within schedule and below expected costs. The building is spread over an area more than 4,700 square meters with over 10 floors and built up area around 25,000 square meters. So recently PM Narendra Modi along with Pravind Jagannath inaugurated the Supreme Court building of Mauritius. Next question. Which Indian activist has been named by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres to his new advisory group on climate change? Indian climate activist Archana Soran has been named by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres to his new advisory group comprising young leaders who will provide perspectives and solutions to tackle the worsening climate crisis as the global body mobilizes action as a part of COVID-19 recovery efforts. So option B, Archana Soran is the correct answer. Archana Soran joined six other young climate leaders from around the world who has been named by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres to his new youth advisory group on climate change. Archana is experienced in advocacy and research, and she is working to document, preserve and promote traditional knowledge and cultural practices in indigenous communities. This Secretary General's Youth Advisory Group, the members of the Secretary General's Youth Advisory Group on Climate Change represent the diverse voices of young Indian people from all regions as well as small island states. They will offer perspectives and solutions on climate change, from science to community mobilization, from entrepreneurship to politics, and from industry to conservation. The young activists aged between 18 to 28 years will advise the UN chief regularly on accelerating global action and ambition to tackle worsening climate crisis. Nazreen Elsaim, she is from Sudan, Ernest Gibson from Fiji, and Sophia Kearney from USA are the other activists, with Archana Soren from India. Next question. Who is the author of the book Quest for Restoring Financial Stability in India? Quest for Restoring Financial Stability in India. Former RBI Deputy Governor Viral V. Acharya has come up with a book titled Quest for Restoring Financial Stability in India, which is a collection of his movement speeches and research as a member of the RBI's Monetary Policy Committee. So, Viral Acharya, option A is the correct answer. Through this book, Dr. Acharya shares a feasible plan to address the recapitalization needs of public sector banks, offering solutions on how to improve credit allocations by credit intermediaries and establish variable and efficient capital markets. And this book is published by Sage Publications India Private Limited. Viral V. Acharya, option A is the correct answer. Next question. Which of the following released the report Toxic to Children's Exposure to Lead Pollution? On 30th July 2020, United Nations Children Fund, that is UNICEF, and Pune Earth International Non-Profit Organization authored and published the first-of-kind report on health crisis titled The Toxic Truth. Children's exposure to lead pollution undermines a generation of future potential states that around lead poisoning affects large number of children all across the globe. The report states that around 1 in every 3, that is around 800 million children across the world, has the blood lead level above or at 5 micrograms per deciliter, the amount at which action is required, and almost 50% of the children live in South Africa. The Toxic Truth is an analysis of childhood exposure to lead conducted by the Institute of Health Metrics Evaluation. It was verified with the study approved for a publication in Environmental Health Prospectives. So, option B is the correct answer, UNICEF. Once again, a quick revision on all these questions. Operation Breathe Space is a joint collaboration mission between which of the following two countries, India and Israel? There are four tests: audio test, breathe test, thermal testing, and polyamino test. Recently, who has been appointed as personal secretary to Prime Minister Narendra Modi? Hardik Satish Chandra Shah has been appointed as personal secretary to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The personalized UPI payment link MPay.me launched by which company? MobiQuick launches the personalized UPI payment link MPay.me. Which of the following is a part of national education policy? Multiple entry and exit options which appropriate collaboration to be available in higher education, board exams for grade 10 and 12 to be discontinued, gender inclusion fund and special education zones to be set up for disadvantaged regions and groups. So, for this statement, 1 and 3 are correct. Option B is the right answer. Which country has formally launched a full global service of its Beidou 3 navigation satellite system, BDS? China. It is the fourth navigation satellite system. First one is USS GPS, second one is Russia's GLONASS, and third one is European Union's Galileo. Ministry of Human Resource Development has been renamed as Ministry of Education. Recently, PM Narendra Modi along with Pravin Jugnauth inaugurated the Supreme Court building of which country? Mauritius. Which Indian activist has been named by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres to his new advisory group on climate change? Archana Soren. Along other six persons, Archana Soren from India has been named by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres. Who is the author of the book Quest for Restoring Financial Stability in India? Viral V. Acharya. Which of the following released the report Toxic Truth: Children's Exposure to Lead Pollution? UNICEF. Guys, I hope all of you answered all these 10 questions. That's it from this session. Have a nice day and thank you for watching. If you like the video, please like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe.